In my last video, I unboxed the brand new NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1080 Ti, the best new graphics card on the market. And now it's time to do something with it. In this video, I'll install the 1080 Ti into Project Sledgehammer, and I'll put it up against the former pair of Titan Nexus. Can the 1080 Ti single-handedly outperform the Titan Nexus in SLI? We'll answer that question and more right after the break.
Welcome to the channel. This is Technoscope.
The OBI-202 by OBI connects to Google Voice to give you free phone service anywhere you have a broadband connection. Click the video card above or visit the link in the description below for the full review. While this is not the first time I've benchmarked a video card, this is the first time I've used a structured method and created an official review of my findings. Despite what other reviewers do, I firmly believe the true purpose of a benchmark is to get an idea of baseline performance. For this reason, I will never benchmark an overclocked graphics card that is not factory overclocked in an official review. The point is to convey to my viewers the minimum amount of performance they can expect, and if I'm able to overclock my GPUs higher than you, then my videos do nothing to help you understand what to expect. Furthermore, I will also run official benchmarks on the stock cooler, as I feel the same about an aftermarket water cooling solution being of no help to those who do not water cool their hardware. This does not mean I will never show overclocked or water cooled results. Those videos just won't be official reviews. To help with any oddities I may encounter while testing, I run each test 3 times at each resolution tested. I record the minimum and maximum frames per second and average those, and for the official benchmarks, I also average the scores. From the 1080 Ti going forward, I also record the average FPS of the test, which may or may not vary wildly from the high-low average. The software I use will change from time to time as needed to remain relevant, but for now, I am using the following software to benchmark hardware: Ghost Recon Wildlands, Rise of the Tomb Raider, Grand Theft Auto 5, Firestrike and Firestrike Ultra, Time Spy, Unigen Heaven 4.0, and Unigen Valley 1.0. All games are ran at their Ultra presets and the official benchmarks at their default settings. With that said, let's start by recapping the specs of Sledgehammer. Sledgehammer is built on an ASUS ZTNPE D16 workstation motherboard with two 2.3 GHz Intel Xeon E5-2696V3 18-core processors with hyperthreading. These processors have the potential to turbo up to 3.3 GHz. Just for clarification, the 2696 is the OEM version of the 2699. It also has 256 GB of error-correcting DDR4 RAM, boots from a 950 Pro SSD, and runs dual Maxwell Titan Nexus. Nearly anything you would like to know about it is in the prior 5 videos of this series. To begin, I removed one Titan X and ran my test as a single graphics card. I then replaced the second Titan X and ran my benchmarks in SLI mode. After all of this, I then removed both Titan X's and installed the 1080 Ti and ran my test again. The results were expected, but still quite impressive to see. You will notice the Titan X results do not have the benchmark FPS average. I did not record those numbers for the Titan X, but going forward, all of my tests, including the 1080 Ti, will have it. This graph is exactly what we expected. In Ghost Recon Wildlands, a single Titan X comes in at a high-low average of 44.72 frames per second at 1080p, definitely lower than the desired minimum 60. In SLI, we jumped to 58.25 FPS, but still just shy of the 60. At 4K, the numbers are almost depressing, coming in at 20.46 FPS in single card config and just 27.01 FPS in SLI. The 1080 Ti, however, not only breaks through the 60 FPS barrier at 1080, but it does it as a single card hitting 66.87 FPS. And averaged 66.79 FPS during the entire benchmark. 4K, however, is a different story. Even the mighty 1080 Ti is not enough to reach anywhere near the 60 FPS mark in this game at Ultra. I'm not sure if that's because the game is so new, or if it's just that demanding. In Rise of the Tomb Raider, the Titan X holds its own with a high-low average of 111.1 FPS at 1080p, and falling just short of 55.3 FPS at 4K. Oddly enough, you will notice the Titan X actually dips in performance at 1080p in SLI. This is one case where you would be better off with a single card if you game at 1080. However, the 4K performance increased as expected. With Titan X's in SLI, I was able to average a high-low value of 67.53 FPS. The 1080 Ti, of course, still dominates here, beating both the single and SLI performance of the Titan X once again with 134.86 FPS and 85.46 FPS in 1080 and 4K modes respectively. The 4K test averaged 63.13 FPS throughout the entire benchmark. In Grand Theft Auto, things get much more interesting. The single card performance of the Titan X and 1080 Ti are nearly neck and neck. This tells me more than likely I hit a bottleneck on the system somewhere. I've heard GTA likes higher clock speeds, and despite my cornucopia of cores, the low clock speed might be holding things back. All the same, in 1080p or 4K, either single card is more than enough to keep you over the 60 FPS desired minimum. Interestingly enough, again we see a dip in 1080p performance with SLI. And the 1080 Ti alone averaged almost a frame per second higher than the Titan X's in SLI in 4K. One thing to note is I didn't include the average FPS on this game because GTA doesn't give you a general overall average like the others. With the next card I test, I will start giving a calculated average of the averages. 3D Mark's Firestrike is available in 3 tests. The standard Firestrike is 1080p while Firestrike Ultra is 4K. I've combined the results as 1080p and 4K in this chart. In 1080p, both cards blow this test out of the water, with the 1080 Ti taking a commanding lead over the aging Titan X. In 4K, however, all of them suffer a fate similar to playing console games, with only the 1080 Ti actually breaking the 30 FPS barrier. The scores reflect a similar outcome, with the 1080 Ti almost breaching the 20,000 mark in 1080p, but is nearly identical in results to the Titan X's in SLI in 4K. The Ghost Recon Wildlands API is unknown to me, and it appears Ubisoft doesn't want you to know, as my Google searches were never able to officially confirm what it uses. TimeSpy, however, is definitely a DirectX 12 test. It also breaks my mold of 1080p and 4K testing by giving me results of a 1440p test. In this test, all three cards came in fairly close to one another, with no card or combination of cards actually reaching 60 FPS. The 1080 Ti does beat the SLI performance of the Titan X's, however. For your comparison, the 1080 Ti obtained a score average of 6,175.67, with the single Titan X falling behind at 5,313.33. Unigen Heaven 4.0, which is undoubtedly the longest benchmark of my test, shows a clear disdain for SLI graphics. The single Titan X had a wonderful 110.17 high-low 1080p average, with the 4K average just under 60 at 53.05 FPS. In SLI, the 1080p performance actually dropped significantly, with only an 11 FPS increase in 4K. Keeping in mind, this test does not even have a 4K setting. It is only obtainable by forcing the benchmark to run at the system resolution. No matter how you cut it, the 1080 Ti is the clear and obvious winner here, with an average of over 60 FPS in 4K mode. The overall score reflects the same results, with the single Titan X coming in second place over SLI, and the 1080 Ti still winning. Unigen's Valley 1.0 is a newer benchmark which appears to be more optimized. However, it too lacks a 4K mode. The single Titan X is still preferable over SLI, as the only win is in 4K for SLI, but by less than 2 FPS, hardly enough to justify using 2 GPUs. The 1080 Ti is still the winner here, taking home a clear trophy in 4K, but only marginally better in 1080p. The scores actually show a slightly different story here, with 4K Titan X SLI taking a clear lead over a single card. It seems the story here is more is only better at higher resolutions. So it would seem the 1080 Ti is definitely the way to go. It doesn't get any better than this. Or does it?
Technoscope is a Twisted Curve production.